and welcome. You're watching Big Wheels and we've got a special episode lined up for you today, of course, it being festive time. And for a special episode, we've also got with us a special guest. Adil's joining us on the show today to share
with
us.
Hi Abba, how are you?
Hi Adil, thanks so much for joining us. Great to have you with us. What's the show about? Well, it's that time of year when everyone goes shopping and we're going to tell you here at Big Wheels with Adil's expert advice exactly what you should be buying. Adil, how are we going to go about this?
We'll look at each segment, look at the premium end of the purchase in that segment as well as the entry level start off point. We'll try to give as wide a choice and an opinion as possible.
Okay, perfect. But before we get going, have a look at what's on the... Before we get started on our Diwali picks, a lot of car companies actually time their new launches with the festive season and Tata Motors has done just that. We're going to bring you a first look on this special episode of Zig Wheels of the Tata Motors Indigo Manza. Have a look and then we're going to come back and talk some more about it. Tata Motors is obviously tired of making plain Jane cars.
Yeah.
The Indigo Manza takes off from where the Indica Vista signed out. And what we have is probably the best looking Tata car till date. The feel is certainly much more upmarket than any other version of the Indigo.
Key segment saloons in India have a new entrant, and in an already overcrowded segment which has got some very, very good vehicles like the Honda Civic, the Ford Fiesta, the Suzuki Swift, Desire, the Suzuki SX4, the Hyundai Verna, the Fiat Linea. Suddenly you have an homegrown rival to all of them, and let me tell you that they have got a lot to be worried about when they take in the new Indigo Manza from Tata Motors.
The Manza comes in two variants. The 1.4-litre Sapphire petrol and the 1.3-litre Fiat-sourced quadrajet diesel engine. The petrol is pretty revvy in nature and should do the business for everyone. But Tata has made its mark in diesel and this one is clearly outstanding. The transmission is a big improvement from that on the Indigo as well.
I'm pottering around here in top gear and she's humming around so very effortlessly. Really seeing the torque spread is from, Tata Motors says the torque spread is from 1750 RPM to 3000 RPM. But everything really starts working from about 2000 RPM onwards. And then after that, she is a strong, strong performer.
Tata Motors showed us that it understands the value of space for an Indian car with the Indica Vista. And the Indigo Manza is yet another manifestation of that philosophy. The dash is totally revamped with a multifunctional indicator in the central console. But the most important fact is the ride position, which is spot on. But if you really want to experience the Manza and have the best of both worlds, don't just sit in the front seat. Try and catch a nap on the back seat, which has near C-class levels of opulence as far as space is concerned.
What we have got is comfort, space and ambience of a class hitherto not ever experienced on a Tata Motors vehicle.
There's nothing to complain about when it comes to handling. Especially considering that the Manza is supposed to be a comfortable and stylish family sedan. And the car will surprise most of us, especially the ones behind the wheel. That's because the Manza offers a fine blend of driver pleasure and occupant comfort.
What we have got is a fantastic ride, very good steering. It could be a little bit sharper, but then given the length of the car, the wheelbase to track ratio, I think it does very well.
The Manza is good value for money. It's competent for sure, and the fit and finish is the best Tata has done till now. But it still has oodles of room for improvement. By and large, the Manza is sure to leave its competitors gasping for breath.
Kick, 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 kick.
this episode of ZigWheels. I don't know about you, but we've had a ball picking out all our favorite cars. Do write in and tell us what you thought at www.zigwheels.com. Adil, thanks so much for joining us.
Grab a copy of the magazine and just let us know what we can do to make it even more better.
That's right. Don't forget, it's on the stands, our very own ZigWheels magazine. We'll catch you next week. Bye for now.